Hello everyone, I am Rajeshwari D, doing a project on machine learning. It is an assignment from a sci-fi lab. The problem statement is predicting the price of a house. In order to implement the model, first I have learned the relationship between the data and the features, which is price, from the Boston data set. Main goal here is to predict the price of a house from a given feature. As a part of the implementation, first of all, what I have done is imported all the libraries like Pandas, NumPy, Matplotlib, Lib, Sklearn, etc. After loading the libraries, we need to load the Boston housing data set from the Sklearn data sets, and we have printed its features using DESCR function, which is shown in the line number 4. Here totally we have 506 rows into 13 columns with the different features. Then if I want to select or print the values of any feature, for example I have taken the age column, then this is how we should print the value of the age, which is shown in line number 6. And the next thing is, we should put the target values into a Panda data frame called target. Therefore, the line number 7 shows how exactly we can copy the data frame into a target, one more data frame called target, and as well as we have shown how exactly we can print the target value or the data frame content. Once again, it has 506 into 1 columns. In order to know about the working of a target data frame, I have put few queries like, I try to find the maximum and the minimum price of the house in the given data, which is computed using the two instruction which is given in line number 10 as well as line number 9. Here the maximum price of the house is 50 and minimum price of the house is 5 in the given data set. The next step is, we need to concatenate features and target into a single data frame. By default it does the row wise concatenation. Then if I want to convert it into column wise, then I have to make axis is equal to 1. The output of the concatenation is shown in the out 12. Then we need to compute the correlation between the features or the every column. Here we are using the Pearson coefficients, correlation coefficients. The step below shows the process of visualizing the Boston housing data set. Here we will visualize the relationship between the features of the data set and the target by using describe function, which provides the statistical description of the data set, and using round we can set the precision to a 2 decimal places. Hence the below table shows the complete description of the data. And also we have used the lambda function here. Here the lambda function is used to extract the key for sorting. And we have set the reverse parameter as true because we want the values in reverse order. Now unzip pairs to two lists. The above operation will take items in a list and unpack as n separate element. Then next, I try to plot the correlation with respect to target as a bar graph. The bar graph here. Next thing is, we have prepared the data for linear regression. Here the LSTAT has the highest absolute correlation. Here the LSTAT has the highest absolute correlation. LSTAT has the absolute correlation with the target, which is the percentage of the lowest status population in the neighborhood. Now, in a neighborhood, if the majority of the population is of lower status, then the prices of the houses will be lower than those in the higher status neighborhood. So here we have prepared the data for linear regression, and the value is shown before the normalization, and which is printed as 21.6 so and so. Therefore, we need to perform the normalization. So, the goal of normalization of the data is to change the values such that after the transformation, all the values lie in a common scale. So, the first x scalar is equal to min max scalar stores the parameter required to normalize the values. Then values are in the range 0 to 1. After normalization, the values are in the range of 0 to 1, and once again it has printed the values and stored in the array Y. The next is we need to define the error. Step 2 is define the error. The choice of the kind of error function depends on the data set. We have used mean squared error because we have continuous data. The choice of the kind of error function depends on the data what we will use here. The next step is we need to split the data, which indicates that 20% of the data is randomly sampled as testing data. Now we have performed the gradient descent, which is an optimization algorithm to minimize a function. It is implemented with three functions: error function, update function, and gradient descent function. The training model. First of all, error visualization. Error visualization, which is shown in the figure. As the number of iteration increases, changes in the line and become less noticeable. So, in order to reduce the processing time for the animation, it is advised to choose smaller values. Therefore, the plot is shown as shown here. Therefore, it is supposed to show us how the regression line changes over the course of. Next step is calculate the prediction on the test as a vectorized output. So here predicted variable holds the prediction on the test, and compute the mean square error for the predicted values on the testing set. After finding the mean squared error, let us put the test, x test and y test, and the predicted value side by side to see how close the predicted and the actual values are, which will be shown in the output 38, what we have expected, and the expected, that is the predicted value as well as the target value. Thank you.